Listen, before starting the class, so what is the content we are going to teach that I will share here? Check. Are you seeing this one? Seeing this one? See, this is the mind map. Our total concept we are going to teach for total 30 or 25 days. What is the name of the chapter? Can you guess anybody? Are you able to see the screen? Students, are you able to see the screen? Okay, you make the thumb up. If you are okay, is that not so clear? See, in that one, you see the first one is dimension of physical quantities. Are you seeing that one? That is the main concept of this. Means you can say that is the chapter. Dimension of physical unit is the main concept we have taken. That is there in 6th class, 7th class, 8th class, 9th, and so on. If you continue, continue study, this will be coming. So dimension of physical quantities. In that one, first if you see on the top left side, dimension formula, limitations of dimensional analysis, physical quantity, measurement. So this comes under the category of measurement. In measurement, physical quantity, units, fundamental quantities, SI units, derived units. In that again units, we have pressure, force, electric potential, frequency, all these concepts which are already familiar in your IIT like that. That all concepts we have based in one. Okay. So these are notes will be given to you regarding this one. Notes will be in the PDF form that will be sent to you. And after this class, we will be having worksheets also. Okay? Now here, you can take your running notes like that. You can take them, note it in your notebook, whatever I am teaching. Let us start the session with one topic. I will take only one topic. So what is that one is? That is called physical quantity. In physics, we are learning physical quantity. Everybody is aware of this one. First, let us recap. What is a physical quantity? A quantity which can be measured. Simple definition. A quantity which can be measured is called a physical quantity. Example, length is a physical quantity which can be measured. Time is can be measured with the help of watch. Mass measured in kg, grams, like that. So the quantity which can be measured are called physical quantity. Area is a physical quantity like that. Okay? Physical quantity. So for that one, we are having some formula or basic or mathematical expression. Okay, like what is the area of rectangle? Means the area of rectangle is equal to the product of length of rectangle and breadth of rectangle. That is the statement. Mathematically, we write it as area capital A is equal to L into B. Similarly, physical quantity means a quantity which can be measured is called physical quantity. So it has length means suppose the product of your house is full. What is the distance between your house and school? Means what you will say? You will say depends upon the distance. 5 meters, 5 kilometers, 2 meters, or 50 meters, like that. The house is near. Okay? So, how much milk you will take in the morning? Some people will say 1 liter, 2 liter, 1 and a half liter, half liter, like that, depending upon the person. Okay? Now, see, 1 liter in the number you have and you will take out. If you purchase any vegetable the cost of 1 kg, then depending upon your capacity, 1 kg, 1 is a number. That number is called a numerical value. Numerical value. Okay? Numerical value into its unit. Okay? 5 liter, 5 into liter. Okay? Like that, 2 liter, 2 into liter. The distance between Sangareddy and Hyderabad is 60 km. to 60 kilometers. Therefore, the quantities which can be measured in terms of physical quantity and we can write it as physical quantity. Is equal to numerical value into 60 ITL. Now, this one example, I'll give one example. I'm giving you 5 in, which means 5 in kilogram. 5 in or 5 kilogram. In that one, 5 is a numerical value and kg is the unit. And this is, I think, everybody is familiar with this one. You have concept tag in your 6th class, 7th class, and 8th class, and the previous classes. You might have concept the triangle, angle, so how draw the line segments also. The question is where in the textbook, the question is where like this. Draw a line segment of 6 cm. Construct a triangle of given following measurement. Okay, like that. So that whatever you have drawn or constructed in your textbook, that is, you have considered a notebook, that will be in centimeter. Did you get any measurement in meters? Meters? No, we did not get that. Centimeters only you have constructed. Okay? So, similarly, what is the physical quantity? So, that means 2 centimeters, means 2 into centimeters. 5 centimeters, 5 into centimeters. 100 centimeters, 180 centimeters. Okay, like that. 1 meter, 1 into meter. So, like this. So, physical quantity means what numerical value is doing. Everyone is clear about this concept? What is a physical quantity? Means a physical quantity is a quantity which can be measured, is called a physical quantity. So it is written as numerical value into its unit. Suppose volume is there. Okay. Volume. So milk will measure in liters. Maybe that is measured in milliliters also. Length. Sometimes it measures in millimeters depending upon the size, okay? Centimeters and also meters, okay? So, what is the physical quantity? The quantity which can be measured is quantity. Physical quantity, and we have having some methods of measurement. So, sometimes I told you if we take only one length, sometimes we are measuring less in centimeters, sometimes we are measuring in meters, and some cases we are measuring in kilometers also. That depends upon the distance. And after that, beyond that part, we are measuring in miles. Okay? Why that is happening? That happens depending upon some systems are there. Systems of measurement we can take. Okay? Systems of measurement. First system is called FPS system. FPS. First system is FPS, system of measure. In this, F is nothing but S, F is the foot, means measurement of length. In this one, F, F is the measurement of length. Measurement of length. S is measuring foot. Foot means 1 foot, 2 foot, 3 feet. Now also we are adopting that method. Whenever somebody asks, what is the height? He will say that 4, 3. What is 4, 3? 4 feet and 3 inches, like that. Did you hear anytime somebody is telling the height like this? Okay, I think you might have. Nobody heard like this. What is the height? Means anybody said like this, my height is 5 kilometer? No answer. Are you hearing? No. So they will be taking 5 feet, 5, 6, 6 feet, like that. They said every time meters, my height is 5 meters, 6 meters, like that. No, they are measuring in feet. Yes, Amani, very good. Please give a response so that the teacher will be active and you will be active. Please participate in the question. Okay, distance is measured in foot. Foot. Okay, now. Where foot is the measurement of length in FPS system. And kilo mass. Mass is measured in pounds. Pound. P-O-U-N-D. Pound. So mass is measured in pounds. Next. This is the second measurement of Now listen here. I'll go to the board. Now listen. What is the measurement of length? Length can be measured in. Length is measured in foot. 1, 4, 4, 3 feet like that. Okay. And denote it with L. Length is measured in foot and denote with length. L means length. Okay. This is the mass. Means pound. M-A-S. Mass is measured in pound. Okay. Newborn baby. So we cannot measure the weight of the baby in kg. Okay. Maximum that will be measured pound. Okay. Pound is less than 1 kg. Okay. Pound. So that is the measurement of mass. And denote it with the letter M. Yeah. Okay. We are using pound. We are using mass. That is the pound is the unit of mass. Okay. Now in the representation, we represent mass with L. And you know, what is the width? Which physical quantity we are measuring in second? Which physical quantity we are measuring in second? Second is the unit of. Very good time. Vyasani, Avani, very good. So it is the unit of time and denoted by letter T. So, before this EPS system, first system was 4 pound second or FPS system. Then this one, F means foot. Distance used to measure or length used to measure in foot. Okay, foot second. So, this you are adopting now also. You may ask, sir, this system is present and now present today also? Yes. If you examine, there is an other indirect part. If you take your scale, if you take your scale, you measure, see the readings on the scale. Did you see the readings on the scale? A short scale has 15 divisions, means 15 centimeters. And long scale has 30 centimeters. Did you observe this one? Long scale has 30 centimeters. Why 30 only? Why 30 only? Did you have doubt like this? Why 30 only? No doubt? Did you get any answer? Why 30 centimeters and big scale is having? Why short scale is having? Only 15 centimeters. Can't it be 12 centimeters in short scale and long scale is 25 centimeters or 24 centimeters? Did you get this kind of doubt? So, yeah, conversion of units comes into action. So, 30 centimeters is equal to 1 feet or 1 foot. 30 centimeter is equal to 1 foot and 15 centimeter is nothing but that is equal to half foot. That's why they are standard scale. Okay, 15 centimeter standard. Okay, 15 centimeter and 30 centimeter scale are there, standard. Okay, 30 centimeter is 1 feet. 15 centimeter is half feet. Okay, first system is half system. In that one, 4 feet is the measure of length. Pound is the measure of mass. And second is the measure of time. So we will measure length. If the physical quantities are measured in foot, pound, and second, then that particular system is called the TS system. That is the first system of measurement. Are you clear about this one? FPS system. Then I'm going by another one. Second measurement, the second type of system of measurement in the one, I can say it is a TGS system. In this, this also, TGS system, this is also depends upon this one. M, mass, length, mass, L, M, S. L is length, M is mass, S is second or time. Okay? So, L, M, CM, DM. Okay. This is centimeter. If the length is given in centimeter, mass in gram, and time in second. This particular system is called TDS system. Suppose if anybody asks, what is the CGS unit of length? What is the answer? If I am asked, I am asking you. Please give me the answer. CGS unit of length. Very good. These are selling centimeter. Deekshita is selling centimeter. Still, Ashwini. Okay, centimeter. Vasavi. Okay. Chakrateja, not second. CGS unit of length. I am asking. Chakrateja, correct your answer. Yeah, very good now. PM no, centimeter, right foot, and the wire writing, we will write for our convenience. Okay? Centimeter. Now, what is the CGS unit of mass? Listen carefully, my question. CGS unit of mass. Gram, very good, Rita. Amani is telling gram. Gram, Vasavi. Satvik, okay, very good. CGS unit of mass is gram. Very good. Now I am asking, listen the question carefully, everybody. Stop typing, listen carefully. What is the CGS unit of time? CGS unit of time. Second. Now second. Okay, no problem. Very good. Chakrateja. Now it is good. Now it is second. Okay, no problem. Listen my question once again. CGS unit, not CGS, now FPS. FPS unit of time. FPS unit of time. FPS unit. Yeah, FPS is also second. See, time units are same for all the systems. In all the systems are measured. Time is measured in second only. Very good, Likita, second. Okay? Now, first system was FPS system. Second system was CDS system. Now, next system, third one is MKS system of measurement. It is MKS system of measurement if the length is measured in meters. Length is measured in meters and mass is measured in kilogram. Okay, kilogram. K stands for kilogram. Kg is not written, kilogram. And the time is measured in seconds. So, meter, kilogram, second. Meter, kilogram, second. So, that means if the length is measured in meters and mass is measured in kilogram and the time is measured in seconds, that kind of particular system is called MKS system. Okay? MKS system. If anybody asks, what is the MKS unit of length? Then what will be the answer? What is the MKS unit of length? Yeah, very good. Nikita, meter, Ashwini, that is the correct answer, meter. Okay, Chakrateja says meter. Now, if anybody asks, what is the MKS unit of mass? Mass, kilogram. Okay, kilogram. So, that is the thing of MKS unit. Now, this is the MKS system. MKS. Foot pound second system. Next one is TGS system. Next one is MKS system. After that, we have last one is international SI system. SI system. SI. SI system. Okay? In SI system, so this SI means full form is standard international. Or international standard system. It is accepted by the throughout the universe, that means throughout the world. Throughout the world, all the countries are accepted this system. That's called international standard system. Or we can say standard international system. Okay? In this one also, the unit, that is MKS system, SI system, units are probably same. Some will be varying. Okay? So, in this one, let me look at it here. SI system of length is meter. Here. Kilograms and time is measured in seconds. Okay, only few points. Like if you take temperature, so CGS is different and Kelvin is the assignment. Kelvin scale in temperature. So don't think length marks, I am only having this kind of thing. Okay, we are having every physical quantity which can be measured. Physical quantity has TPS in it, MPS in it, and SI in it. Okay, thing is only we have to recognize. Now we come across this word. One is what is physical quantity, you know, computed. Second one is system part, means type of system. There are four types of systems of measurement. Foot pound second, MPS system. Next one is TPS system, MPS system, and SI. And this we are having system of measurement. See, in physics, if you go across any physical quantity, you have to name it according to its system and unit. Suppose you go to a shop, if you are asking for ice, you cannot say, give me 2 liters of ice. You have 2 kg of ice. Okay, so like this. So everybody, every physical quantity is having some specific standard and technique. Okay, now how this has come? How these techniques has come? What are the basic qualities? Okay, we have a fundamental quality and derived quantity. Fundamental and derived quantity. We have learned already fundamental means what, derived means what. Listen, students, some people have left the class. Don't leave the class. Attendance is being taken at the last moment of the class. Two students left the class. Maybe the problem with the net, that may be anything. Try to join the class until the last. There were 25 and down 23. 3 left. 2 left. Please don't leave the class. If you have any problem, please intimate to the class teacher. Because attendance is there, but recording is attendance at the last. If you attend the class totally, then only attendance is being given. Okay, now let us know fundamental quantity. Quantities which can be measured physically, like length. To measure length, is there any formula? Can you say any formula to measure the length? Do you have any formula or technique to measure the time? Formula in mathematics, like area of rectangle, you know, length into breadth. Area of triangle, half into, no formula, okay? And let's see, what we have to do to measure the length? What we have to do to measure the length? We have to take a scale, or we have to take the tape, measuring tape, or we have to take the survey tape, you know, to measure. Am I right or not? You want to measure length, you have to take the tape. To measure mass, is there any formula? No formula. What you will do? You have to take Raman balance or spring balance or electronic balance, like this. Mass is made in Raman balance. Time is made in watch, that is a measuring device. So these quantities, which can be measured physically, they are called fundamental quantities or basic quantities. Fundamental quantities or basic quantities. Example, length, mass, time, temperature, electric current. Brightness of the light, that is called luminous intensity, and so on. Okay, angle. See, what is solid angle? Angle also will measure their protraction. There is no power to measure the angle. Okay, so which can be measured? These are called fundamental quantities or basic quantities. Fundamental quantities or basic quantities. The quantities which we are measuring physically with the help of other instruments and recording the readings. These are fundamental quantities, and derived quantities, these are the fundamental. Example, length, mass, time, temperature, okay, heat, okay, Next one is luminous intensity, electric current, like that. Now, next one is what is derived qualities? Derived. Fundamental qualities are also known as, the derived qualities are the physical qualities which are obtained from the fundamental quantities. Derived qualities are the qualities which are obtained or which we get from the fundamental qualities. Example I will take. Okay, I will explain this one in brief. But example, if you want to find, okay, T is equal to, you know, distance by time. Now, you know, what is the CGS rate of distance? How only I know? What is the CGS rate of distance? CGS unit of distance. Very good. Centimeter. By CGS unit of time. Very good. Meter. Second. Therefore, centimeter per meter is the CGS unit of speed. Centimeters per second. Or CM slash S. Is the CPS unit of sector speed. So this centimeters per speed is called derived quantity. This is a fundamental quantity distance. And this is the time of the fundamental quantity. By taking two fundamental quantities, one derived quantity has come. The derived quantity is not a fundamental quantity. So length of speed, velocity, uniform speed, uniform velocity, acceleration, uniform acceleration, force, pressure, and so on. These are called derived quantities which are getting from the fundamental quantities. Are you aware of this one, everybody? Today's topic. So here I will resume my class. See what we have learned by this physical quantity, type of measurement, four types of measurement: FPS, BPS, MKS, and SI. Next, what is fundamental quality and what is derived quality? Okay, regarding this, worksheet will be shared to you. Please do the worksheet and keep with you. We will be taking that one. Okay, do the worksheet. Worksheet will be sent to you in your WhatsApp group. Any doubts also you can ask. Meanwhile, you stay. We are taking your attendance. Now this is a thing. If you are having any doubt, you can ask. Otherwise, I will end the class. I will end the class today. We'll go for next class. Any doubt? Any queries? Any doubts regarding the class? Not only now, we can ask after the class also. Please read the material will be given in the form of PDF file. Worksheets will be sent to you. Read the material and do the worksheets and send the answers. Okay? Keep with you. Be alert. And today's class, if you don't have any doubt, I will resume. I will end the class today and let us meet with new learning skills from tomorrow. With new concept. Okay, Vasavi, thank you. Thank you, everybody. Have a nice day.